Well, T-minus 9 days until the London Olympics. And you know the difference between winning or losing, between gold or silver. When it comes down to the marathon, it could actually be a millisecond or a millimeter that will earn that top medal. And behind those awards, well, is usually a pretty extraordinary coach. Ryan Hall knows exactly what I'm talking about. He is among the best long-distance runners in the world. And he'll tell you, he does have the ultimate coach. But the thing is, Ryan's coach isn't there with a timer yelling at him about his footwork or getting on to him about his diet or even telling him he better make curfew. But Ryan says his coach is always there, everywhere, and basically knows everything that he's doing. Olympian and marathoner Ryan Hall joining me from Flagstaff, Arizona, where he is training right now for the games. So, Ryan, tell us about your coach and why you've got so much faith in him.
Yeah, well, my coach has been around for a long time, and, you know, just to put it straightforward, my coach is God. I call it faith-based coaching because, you know, I supply what I learned in my faith through the Bible and through worship, through other people, and I apply that to my running.
In fact, after you won second place last year in the U.S. Half Marathon Championship, I was seeing that you actually wrote down on a drug test form, because that's standing operating procedure after you place, that your coach is God.
Yeah, that was a pretty funny moment. You know, that was my first race under faith-based coaching. And, you know, I saw the line and it said coach and it was blank. And I was like, well, you know, I have to be honest. And so I put God down. And it turned into kind of a big controversial thing. And so, you know, now whenever I see that blank, I just leave it blank. I'll just let that one slide by. But it was pretty funny.
All right. So I want you to explain your faith-based coaching, how it works every day when you wake up. And just to point out, you ran your personal best, I was told, last year at the Boston Marathon, 2 hours, 4 minutes, 58 seconds. So explain to me how God trains you.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm still in process and I'm still figuring this thing out myself. And so, you know, I don't have it all figured out yet, but, you know, it's pretty simple. Like, I just get up every morning or whenever I'm praying, you know, God's always around us, always talking to us. And I just ask him questions. And, you know, I think a lot of times people have faith, but they don't really integrate it into their day-to-day living. And for me, I got to the point in the fall of 2010 where I was like, I want to put myself in a position where I'm desperate to hear from God. And so, you know, I felt God calling me to do this faith-based coaching, and that's what I've done. So, you know, I ask God questions like, you know, how far do you want me to run today? And I remember before the Olympic trials, this last trials, I was asking God, you know, how do you want me to prepare this last week? And I felt like he was telling me, you need to rest more than you've ever rested before. And so I did that, and, you know, as a result, was able to qualify for my second Olympic team.
And you're obviously a really amazing runner, and you're doing really well. But I'm going to play devil's advocate here for a second. You're still not number one, like the best runner in the world. So why not add to your faith-based coaching and take on a traditional coach as well? Why not do that?
Yeah, you know, I'm just doing what I feel like God's calling me to do for this season of my life. And, you know, I've been very intentional when I talk about faith-based coaching to tell people, you know, this might not be something that I do for the rest of my career, but I feel like God's calling me to do this right now. So I'm going to do it for the meantime. You know, if he brings another coach into my life, I will definitely, you know, have no hesitation to start working with the coach. But for now, I feel like this is what God is telling me to do. And I don't think it's for everyone. You know, my wife is also a professional runner and she has a traditional coach and that works great for her. And I encourage her to keep doing that. So, you know, I realize God's calling us all to do different things. So I'm just trying to be obedient and follow him.
So Ryan, what do you say to the skeptical runners out there that say, okay, I respect him. That's cool. But okay, he's nuts.
Well, you know what? Like, I love the skeptic, and God loves the skeptic, and, you know, it's okay for people to disagree with what I'm doing. I don't expect everyone to understand. In fact, you know, probably very few people will totally understand, but, you know, like, for me, I'm just going after God with everything that I have, and it's a really fun journey. Like, as I've gone out on this faith-based coaching, I've just experienced a ton of peace and joy, and it's just brought a whole new level of just life to my running. Like every day I wake up excited for my training and believing that my training is making me better than I otherwise could have been. So, you know, I wouldn't compromise anything, even if the results aren't what I'd hope to get achieve. My day-to-day living is full of joy, and that's something that God offers to all of us. So that's the cool thing about God. You know, there's only one guy that can win the Olympic marathon, but we can all experience him every single day and experience that same joy every day.
So let me ask you then on that note, when you don't get the time that you want, or you don't make it as far as you wanted to go, or you don't get first place, do you blame God?
Yeah, it's easy to do that, and I've certainly done that at times, you know, and like I said, I'm still figuring this out myself, and I still get bummed out after races and disappointed, but, you know, I don't think God causes me to fail in races. You know, I don't think he's up in heaven just striking me down, being like, I want you to do bad today, but, you know, I think there's natural consequences when, say, for example, I don't hear him correctly, and I don't apply what he's telling me to do correctly, and then I might not get the result that I'm hoping for, and, you know, that's okay. I'm learning to give myself grace to mess up and to fail. And I think that's really the whole freeing thing for me in this faith-based coaching is that, you know, I'm not afraid to fail because I feel like, as I said before, like Jesus is the greatest prize I can have. So, you know, a medal in the Olympics, fast times, all those things are wonderful and super exciting and things I'd love to achieve. But, you know, all those are just icing on the cake for me.
But I tell you what, if we all extended ourselves a little grace now and then, we'd all be better people. Tell me how people react when they see you and they see how good you are. They're competing against you and there's other coaches around and someone says, oh, Ryan, by the way, if they don't know who you are, who's your coach? And you say, God. How do they react to you?
You know what? Honestly, I don't pay a whole lot of attention to a lot of the reactions I get. I just try and stay focused on what I'm doing. But yeah, you get some varying reactions for sure. You know, I think some of my peers are surprised that, you know, I'm willing to take a risk. Even some of my best friends are like, wow, man, that's a really bold move you're making. And I'm just like, well, you know, that's what God's telling me to do. So like I said, I'm just being obedient and I don't put it on anyone else. You know, I don't expect all Christians to have God for their coach. But for me, that's where I'm at this point.
Well, it sounds like you've got two missions, to win the gold and also to witness to everybody you meet. We'll be watching you as you compete in the Olympics, Ryan. Best of luck, and hopefully we'll talk again. If indeed you bring back that gold, there might be a lot of people wanting a piece of your coach.
Hopefully they want a piece of them anyways. But yeah, I appreciate it.
Ryan Hall, thanks so